Entitled dad bullies my mum's friend to get his kid an A. Upsetting thing is, I'm pretty sure this is still happening. So my mum and her friend are teachers. They both teach second grade. I'm just going to refer to he as MF to make it easy. Anyway, the ED's kid isn't an A student, and that isn't really his fault. However, he isn't happy with it. He's been sending emails to MF, basically bullying her into getting his child an A. I don't know much about the details of the emails, but I assume it's stuff along the lines of, "You're a bad teacher, how could you not get them an A? They deserve it." Worst thing about it is that entitled dad is above her education wise, as in he's some high school director or something. Not sure exactly what. MF, my mum, and the dean of the school know he's wrong, but what can they do? Entitled kid destroys my kite. Entitled mother doesn't care. This happened 6 years ago, but I just remembered it, and I think it should go on this subreddit. I had a small green kite that was $8. I know it's not that much, but still. I was in a small park and just raised my kite into the wind. It was a really nice sensation, seeing the kite flying. But my happiness stopped as soon as entitled kid arrived. She was younger than me by 2 years, I think. But even though she was autistic, her mother doesn't do anything about it. The girl goes to a normal school, and she punches, kicks, and bites other children. And her mother always says she's autistic, let her be. And also, entitled mother spoils entitled kid to death, and doesn't even try to discipline her. I understand that she's mentally disabled, but I know an autistic kid who is very nice to others. So it's possible. But no, entitled mother thinks that because her child is autistic, she can do whatever she wants without any consequences. Entitled kid came rushing to me, kicked me in the balls for no fucking reason, grabbed the kite string and brought the kite to the ground, and starts stomping on it, all this time screeching like a banshee. Then she runs away and I pick up the piece of the kite and go to entitled mother. The conversation went something like this. The cast is OP me, entitled kid, and entitled mother. "Excuse me, ma'am." "What?" "Entitled kid destroyed my kite. You know this is destruction of property, right?" "That doesn't count for her. She's autistic. She doesn't need to suffer from consequences." "So you tell your child that it's okay to destroy other people's property?" Entitled kid then scratches me hard. I was bleeding, so I just ran home to clean my bleeding arm. I often see them. Entitled mother always gives me a death glare, and entitled kid still screeches like a banshee. Entitled mother is the referee of entitled kid's soccer game and favours him heavily. Not really important, just a quick little rant about I was 10 when this happened, so it wasn't impactful in any way. Me, MR, entitled mother referee, EK's entitled kid. EK and I were on the opposing teams in a soccer game. We were both under 11 years old, so it wasn't very serious. However, my team was vastly superior to his. We scored 2 goals within 10 minutes. Entitled kid and entitled mother recognised this and decided they had to be unfair if they even had a chance of winning. They resorted to shameless fouling and favouring. Entitled kid would shove people into the ground and entitled mother would do nothing about it. This happened many times to the point where other protective mothers were getting angry. If anyone ever came close to entitled kid, he would dive on the ground and get a free kick. The worst call she made was when entitled kid attempted to shoot the ball on goal and I, the goalkeeper, stopped it from going in. But entitled mother said that it was a goal and that it had crossed the line. Thomas had never seen such bullshit before. When I argued with entitled mother, I received the responses, "I'm the referee, I have all of the power," and "stop crying, you're just upset that entitled kid is clearly better than your entire team," before getting a yellow card. Despite all of that bullshit, we still kicked their asses 13-2. After that, I never saw entitled mother or entitled kid ever again, so I assume they were kicked out of the league, something that can happen frequently. Parent tries to take my birthday money. Ah yes, so when I was about 10 or 9, I went to go to a bowling alley. So we all have fun, then my mum got me money for my birthday, while my friends and I were playing. So I open up the card, and in the corner of my eyes, I see this one kid take a glimpse at it. 30 seconds after I get the money, he starts staring at the money, then walked up to me and said, "Hey, can I take some of the money? I'll pay you back once me and my mum have to go. This man is 10. And at the time, I was kind of in a state of shock, so I kind of said, "No, sorry." So he didn't take it that well, so he went to his mum saying, "I took his money." 5 minutes later, I kind of brushes it off, but then I get a tap on the back. Guess who it is? His friggin' mother. I was so goddamn scared, this bitch was like 6'3". She started yelling shit like, "Give the motherfucking money back to my son, you pathetic little piece of shit." I started to freeze, kind of like a fight or flight moment, so I started running towards my dad. But then surely enough, he wasn't anywhere near me, but he was near the woman. My dad started getting... Oh, Jesus. My dad started getting spit on his face from how much she was telling at him, but soon enough, the workers started to get her out of the place, and then her son flipped the bird at me. Fucking bums, am I right? Hentai Dujin, stash destroyed. Me and E, LC's little cousin, EA's entitled aunt. So my aunt and cousin were over at my house. After I'd noticed that, I noticed that little cousin is gone. I go up to my room to see him pouring water on my Dujin and Hentai stash that I keep in my bottom drawer. I knew that little cousin had been searching deep because I keep them buried under a layer of assorted clothing. Here's the conversation that followed. Why are you destroying my books? They were rude and my mummy told me not to read them. But why the heck were you looking in my room anyway? I thought you weren't allowed in my room. Well, mummy said that I can. Did she tell you to look in my closet? What's going on? Your little kid just destroyed my manga collection. Well, if they were inappropriate, then why did you own them? I'm 17. I'm allowed to read this. Well, you shouldn't have put them in a place where Elsie can reach them. Simple. These cost money. Tough. Entitled single mum co-worker. EM is entitled mum, tears trainer, me is me. I'm actually not involved in the story, just a witness. This was about 6 years ago. Some of the specifics are a little blurry. I'd just gotten hired at a call centre and it was the first day of training. The company hired people in groups and trained them in groups. I was in a group of about 30 people. We were in a large room with computers lined up against the walls and each of us sat at a computer. The trainer guy stood in the middle and talked to us all. Everything was pretty neutral and boring in the beginning. The trainer was doing the usual explaining stuff about the company and getting everybody familiar with each other. As we would go over things, people would either raise their hand to ask questions and some would just ask their questions with no prompts. Everyone was civil. As trainer started discussing things like schedule policies, days off and stuff like that, that's where entitled mother started making a spectacle of herself and would just pop off with her question. Every question she would ask she was prefaced with, as a single mum. Trainer was good about answering her questions, but I could tell he was getting a little annoyed. After the 10th or so question, justice was served. As a single mum, blah blah, do I get special treatment, blah blah, my kids are my world, blah. Believe it or not, you're not the only single parent that works here, nor will you be the last. I myself am a single parent. There are company policies that everybody must follow and nobody gets special treatment. That shut her up quickly. I wheezed, trying to stifle my laughter. Entitled aunt allows cousin to break our TV. Okay, I tell you that this is where I was around 10 or 11 years old. I was in the summer and entitled aunt had told her hellspawn entitled cousin that he could sleep at our place since we had a free bedroom as I moved to the room downstairs near the kitchen. Entitled kid comes over and he is a fucking terror for the 2 days he is there. He screams a lot, punches my little sister, bites big sister, calls mum a slag, British slang for slut, and tells me that I don't belong in the family because of my stutter. You're an embarrassment to our family. Your stuttering is annoying and it makes you look like a fucking retard. Your mum should disown you. Keep in mind, this came from a kid the same age as my little sister. I just started grabbing by his hair and pushed his face into the kitchen counter, knocking out two of his teeth. I had lost it. My mum ran in while entitled cousin was screaming and she saw the blood. She scolded me for being so violent and told me I didn't need to take things so far. Entitled cousin then runs into the living room while he's crying, grabs the TV and pushes it off the display case. The screen shatters and my little sister is crying. Biggest sister wants to beat entitled cousin, but she saw the damage to him by me. Mum called entitled aunt and told her that entitled cousin shouldn't come anymore and to pick her crotch devil up. Entitled aunt is there within 2 hours. Entitled aunt fucking beats me until my back is purple and then kicks me in the ribs while I'm on the floor sobbing. Mum grabs entitled aunt by her hair and drags her outside, pushing her out the door. She then drags entitled cousin out and locks them both out. Entitled aunt never came again after that, but she told other families that we were savages who needed to be locked up in a cage. I fucking hate how shitty some family can be. That is rough. That's fucking rough. Jesus. Entitled mother thinks she has me in a trap. Okay, so this is just a short and sweet encounter. We were hosting a party at my house, and the thing is that we were all Indian and mostly Hindu. Because of that, a lot of the people there were vegetarians. I, on the other hand, ate fish and chicken, so I decided to microwave some leftovers. A mum of one of my sister's friends came in and saw me taking out the forbidden bird. She gasped and she acted if I had just killed the chicken right there in front of her. She then demanded me clean my hands, which weren't even dirty, and clean the kitchen after I sealed it with that mess. I was just like, I got this from the fridge on a plate, then to a microwave, nothing else. Well, this mum said that she wanted me to shut the microwave and clean my hands and the whole microwave so her kids don't have the food mixed with the mess that is a meat. I decided to test our patient and just eat the whole meal in front of her. She demanded me close the microwave, then clean it. While I was there, 3 feet from her. After that, I cleaned my hands, closed the door, and walked away. Lo and behold, I walk into the party, and all the food is already put out with her kids gorging in pizza and brownies. I took a glance at her and just gave her kids a slice of pizza, clearly with my hands that were clean, just not by her standards.